Hello everyone, Victor is here. In today's video, the challenge is to paint without underdrawing. First of all, I'm soaking the paper with a lot of water, with a large flat brush designed for watercolor. Then I'm diving in with watercolor. The watercolor set today is Nevskaya Palitra or White Night portable set. I am beginning laying out the clouds in random directions to obtain the fluffy clouds. When wet color is dropped on a wet surface, like in this case, this technique is called wet on wet technique, and is very suitable for depicting clouds, because clouds don't have a very definite shape. I decided to paint without underdrawing because this approach makes you think in terms of layers rather than a definite shape made by underdrawing. Sometimes I caught myself while painting after drawing that instead of painting rather a unified picture, I was coloring in the shapes, like in a case of coloring book. Lately, I've been using this approach of painting directly with watercolor, especially when painting on location, when urban sketching, because it allows to save time when you are in a hurry and you don't waste time making the underdrawing. Here is a mixture of blue color and yellow ochre. When you get this dull muted green, excellent for depicting some grass or greenery. Charging directly with yellow color to brighten up a bit this green and to make some highlighted areas. In the middle bottom part, I'm leaving the white of the paper untouched, painting negative shape of a pathway that goes in the distance. Actually, painting negative shapes helps a lot when approaching the watercolor in this way. Also, when painting directly with watercolor, you should plan in advance and to make a mental plan of how the proportions and relative shapes will lay on paper. Here It's a mixture of a brownish color. And I am drawing the shape of the rooftop with the edge of the large brush. A large brush can help you to build confidence in watercolor. Also, being a flat brush, it helps you to draw straight lines. As you can see, the edge of the rooftop can be described very well with the tip of the brush or the flat edge. I'm painting the rooftop of the house in the distance, and when painting, I'm leaving a small white stripe between this rooftop and the first rooftop. This technique allows you to highlight some parts of composition, and also when working with watercolor, it prevents the color to merge with the neighboring color. When working on a good quality paper like this, this paper is made by SMLT Art. It's 100% cotton. When you lay down the color, you can control very well where the color will go. Painting with transparent washes is one of the watercolor advantages. Even though the sky can be seen on the previous layer, this effect unifies the whole image. I'm not sure about the result of this painting. I'm just experimenting and playing with watercolor. I think to take the huge pressure of your shoulders of creating a so-called masterpiece, you just need to shift the mindset of creating something extraordinary to the one of just playing. You just play, you don't worry about the results. Play and observe what happens. I switched to a smaller brush, a round pointed brush, and fiddling around, just trying to figuring out where some details of these houses might be. This view, I was inspired after I visited the National Village Museum in Bucharest. These are rural houses that can be met in traditional Romanian villages. For these houses, I'm continuing also with negative shapes. After the first layers dried a bit, so that I can control better the direction of watercolor. In some places, the color bleeds and spreads. It's not a problem, I'm fine with that. I don't intend to make the picture all focused. Some edges are better defined, some are not so good. I think this effect of found and lost adds interest to a picture. I remember using watercolor when I was a child. I didn't know at that time all the properties of watercolor, that it should be transparent. Watercolor is a light medium. It is applied from light to dark. The white of the paper should be preserved for the reflections. The pure white doesn't exist in nature. I remember that I had assignment for homework at art classes. The paper was a regular one for drawing. I used the watercolor as a coloring medium. I think I would had better used gouache instead of watercolor. One instance when I started using the full potential of watercolor was when I started attending art classes organized for school children by local council. On the first lesson, I had to paint still life, and it was a vase with a spherical shape base and a long thin neck. The color of the vase was yellow ochre, the color of straws. I remember using blue color for the shade of this vase. After a few months or a scholar year, I didn't continue going to these classes. Did I get bored? Didn't I have time to go after school? Did I was told that I didn't have any talent for drawing? I don't remember. But after this short encounter with art learning, I stopped at that moment. Indeed, I was critiqued by my teachers about mistakes I was doing, but that critique and indicating my mistakes helped me to learn. There are things learned in that short period that I still remember today, about proportions, shadows. 20 years later, I'm starting to be interested in art again. Why did it take 20 years to start drawing again? Maybe I was bored. I took some random classes in drawing and painting. I don't remember my school watercolor kit. Brushes, pencils. The paper was in sketch pads. I don't remember to have seen sketchbooks I remember that I had some assignments, a few homeworks for art classes. I had to draw a horse, and I was struggling to draw the limbs of the horse. When I brought the drawing to the class, my teacher told me that I copied it from a book instead of drawing it from observation, and gave me a low mark. Another homework was to draw a scene from our homes. So I drew our house, the yard, trees, a dog house, and the dog. When I brought the drawing in the class, the teacher told me that I painted the dog in green and put a question mark next to the dog. I remember that I was struggling with drawing for homeworks. I had the lowest marks at sports, music, and art classes. And that thing bothered me, because these marks lowered my average mark. To increase my mark at sports, I tried to exercise at home. For example, I remember sticking to poles in the ground and putting a thread between them to train my height jump. Height jump was one of the sport tests to pass a quarter. Other tests that I remember were pull-ups, which I did around 5 or 6, and for a better mark they should have been at least 10. Then abdominal crunches, a certain number in a minute, which I did decently. Long distance running, I also managed short distance running. I remember that for music classes, to increase my mark, I subscribed to local school choir and sang there once a week. If a talent is something that comes easy, I can conclude that I wasn't talented at music, sports, or drawing. Maybe I want to do more of what I cannot do. Before starting drawing again a few years ago, I tried to play guitar and sing, but I wasn't satisfied with the results, even though I enjoyed practicing. I switched to a smaller brush to suggest some other details with the broad stroke and a color that is consistency of butter. You can obtain different textures. I'm not trying to depict all the details, just a suggestion that something might be there. In this approach of direct painting, the actual drawing comes at the end. I tried many media before stopping by the watercolor. I find it most suitable for my habits of sketching and for urban sketching. A small portable palette can always fit in my backpack or even in my pocket. Portability and easy to use are my main criteria to choose art supplies and materials recently. When you don't have much time or space to dedicate to your passions, you can always adapt. This also can be a creative process. This sketch is very simple, but can depict a mood or atmosphere. It catches the play of light and shadow. For the darkest parts or shadow, I'm using a mixture of ultramarine blue and sepia. I discovered quite recently sepia color. It's very useful for urban sketching or landscapes. It's a neutral color. You can always add sepia to other colors to make them muted or to make less saturated and to unify a painting. This small brush is very useful for drawing such small details like fences, poles, or planks of wood. This also is a game of finding details that can be hidden in the whole picture. I accidentally dropped a few blobs of color on the sky. I'm not bothered by this. It adds interest to the painting. These small dots can be like leaves in the wind or birds. Now I'm experimenting with a toothbrush, splattering color and adding texture to the painting. I'm using burnt umber. This is always a fun technique to use a toothbrush. It adds interest. Now I'm using the smallest brush, a very thin one, adding a few poles on the roof tops. I like adding these small details at the end. When I'm almost finished, I always refrain myself to not overdo with too many details, because too many details can clutter and make the picture too busy. The picture should breathe. It has to have some areas of large washes, some areas of compact details, with dark, with light. It should be balanced with all the elements. I think it's time to sign this sketch and to date it, because I tend to forget when I painted them, and I made this habit of signing and dating them. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.